Hi. An illuminated body is kept under the water at a depth of what? H meters. So usually, whenever a light ray is incident on the interface that separates two different media, one is called denser medium like water and a rarer medium like air, what is going to happen? The refracting ray bends away from the normal, from its original position. This is the initial direction of the incident light ray. It will. So it bends away from the normal. Right. This ray is bending away from the normal. If the angle of incidence is increased further, see in the second case, the angle of incidence is increased. This is equals to critical angle. Here the angle of incidence I is less than what critical angle. This is what? Less than critical angle. Another one is I is equals to what? Equal to critical angle. Third one is what? I is greater than what? Critical angle. I am considering three different cases. You must understand these three cases. If the angle of incidence in the denser medium is less than critical angle, the ray bends away from the normal. That cannot be seen by the observer actually, because it is going in such a certain direction. And another ray that is traveling, that is making an angle that is equal to critical angle here. So it grazing the surfaces. It grazes the surface. Because the angle of refraction will be 90 degrees and the angle of incidence, corresponding angle of incidence in the denser medium is called critical angle. Fine. And third case, third ray that is incident on this interface, so that the angle of incidence is more than critical angle. This angle will be equals to what? I will be greater than what? Critical angle. If it is greater than critical angle, total internal reflection takes place. So the ray is totally internally reflected in the same medium. So the angle of incidence must be equals to angle of reflection. This is called total internal reflection. So first ray is incident at an angle that is less than critical angle, so that it is so moving away from the normal. And the second ray is incident on the interface at an angle that is equal to critical angle, it is grazing the surface. Third ray is incident at an angle that is equal to greater than critical angle, so it is totally internally reflected. On the same way, other side also you can see. Three rays are proceeding from the, we have considered three rays from the illuminated object. The first ray is incident at an angle less than critical angle, so that the ray is moving away from the normal. The second ray is incident at an angle equals to critical angle, so it is grazing the surface. Third ray is incident on the surface interface, so that the angle of incidence will be greater than what? I is greater than critical angle, so total internal reflection takes place. Total internal reflection takes place. Children, you please come and see. Light, actually, for total internal reflection, there are two important conditions. What are those two important conditions? Light is incident on the denser medium. So, it has to travel from denser medium into what? Rarer medium. Light is incident on the interface from denser medium. First condition. The second condition is, angle of incidence in the denser medium should be greater than critical angle. So, if these two conditions are satisfied, then only total internal reflection takes place. So that is, of course, we know very well. Now our interest is different. What is our interest? Yeah, see here, all of you see here. A luminous object is kept in a denser medium at a height of what? H. At a height of what? H. So this height is now taken as what? This height is, the total height is now taken as what? Height is what? H. This total height is H. The refractive index of denser medium is mu d. Refractive index of rarer medium is mu r. This is air medium, you consider this as water. Refractive index of denser medium is more than the refractive index of what? Rarer medium. Denser medium, light travels what? With less speed. And light travels with more speed in what? Rarer medium. That's why the speed of light in this denser medium is say V, and the speed of light in what? That is rarer medium is what? C0. C0 is definitely more than what? C. Right. Refractive index gives an idea of what? How fast or slow the light ray is traveling in that particular medium. So at a height h from the interface, which is separated two different media, refractive indices mu r and mu r cut. R is what? R stands for rarer medium and d stands for what? Denser medium. Now I am considering three different rays as I explained you. Ray 1. As ray 1 strikes the surface at an angle of incidence less than what? Critical angle, and gets reflected in air medium. Sorry, gets refracted in air medium. This is refracted in the air medium. This is a refracting ray. Right. Second ray. What is the second ray? This is the second ray. So it has a special characteristic. What is the special characteristic? The angle of incidence for that ray is equals to what? So the second ray, it strikes the surface at an angle equal to what? Critical angle, I is equal to C. So if the angle of incidence is equal to critical angle, the ray is going to graze the surface like this. It is growing like grazing the surface. So that is, it is now grazing the surface. Critical angle, angle of incidence, graze the surface. So a ray, the third ray if you consider, it strikes the surface at an angle greater than what? Critical angle. And it gets what? Internally reflected. So the total internal reflection takes place. If the angle of incidence for the third ray is more than critical angle, total internal reflection is taking place. So children, all of you please remember, the first ray is incident at an angle which is less than critical angle of the denser medium with respect to rarer medium. Second ray is incident at an angle equals to critical angle of the denser medium with respect to rarer medium. So third ray is incident at an angle that is what? Greater than critical angle. So then what is going to happen? Total internal reflection takes place. These three rays everyone has to consider and remember. The first ray is refracting the same medium. The second ray is refracting in the same medium but grazing the surface. So this could be the maximum angle of refraction. And third ray is, it is totally internally reflected. So now my interest is to find out or establish a relationship between what? The radius of this circular path. Why this circular path is formed? If you see in this direction, it is grazing like this. If you see in this direction, it is grazing like this. So that, so the locus of points where it strikes at a circular angle, at a critical angle. So the locus of points where it strikes at critical angle, the locus of all the points where the light ray which is proceeding from this illuminated body strikes. Okay, so that locus forms a circle. The locus of points where it strikes at a critical angle is a circle of radius r. So that is called circle of illumination COI. Circle of illumination is what? A man, one who is in the rarer medium, can see that light is coming only from the circular aperture. With this circular aperture, he is able to see the light in a circular aperture. Yep. So that the radius of the circular aperture is equal to what? R. So circle of illumination is seen here. This circle of illumination is a great importance because a fish in water sees the external in a circular aperture like this. It is seeing it a circular aperture like this. So a conic section is going to be formed. Observer in rarer medium sees the light from only circle of illumination. Only circle of illumination is able to see, a fisherman able to see the light is from only the circle of illumination. Alright. The vertex angle of the cone formed with what angle? Vertex angle 2C. So what is the angle that is made by this one? This is total angle, is this side, it is critical angle C. The other side, the angle that is made by this incident ray with the normal is C. And the angle that is made by this incident light ray with the normal is again C. C plus C is 2C. So vertex angle of this conic section is equal to what? 2C. So now you can imagine a circle. What is the circle? You can see here. You can imagine a right angle triangle. You can imagine. See now, this is a right angle triangle. You can see a right angle triangle here. This is a right angle triangle. So this is a right angle triangle. See, A, B, O is a right angle triangle. From this right angle triangle, what is the value of tan C? Tan C is equal to what? So it is the ratio of the opposite side to what? Adjacent side. That's why I have written AB by what? AO. ABB is the opposite side. AO is called what? Height. Therefore, I have written R by H. Tan C is equal to R by H. But tan C, according to the trigonometric ratios, that is, tan C is always equals to what? Ratio of sine angle of sine C by what? Cos C. So tan C can be written as what? Sine C by cos C. So let us calculate the value of sine C first. We know that sine C is equal to sine critical angle. Sine of critical angle is always equals to what? The refractive index of rarer medium with respect to what? Refractive index of denser medium. Sine C is equal to mu r by bd. But mu r value is A. For A, the value of mu r is 1. And mu d is what? Refractive index of denser medium, I call it as mu. Therefore, sin C is equal to 1 by mu, we have already established this relationship. The relation between critical angle and what? The refractive index is already calculated. So, therefore, sin C is equal to what now? 1 by mu. As sin C is equal to 1 by mu, so let us find out the cos V value. Sin square C plus cos square C is always 1. So, then cos square is equal to 1 minus sin square C. So, 1 minus sin square C means 1 by mu square, because sin C is equal to 1 by mu. That can be written as mu square minus 1 by mu square. Cos square C is equal to mu square minus 1 by mu square. Hence, the value of what? That is, cos C is equal to what now? What is the value of cos C? Cos C, see here, under root mu square minus 1 by what? Mu. Mu square under root is equal to mu. That's where it is. You know the value of cos C. So this we got cos c value we got here, and also we got sin c value. So what is sin c value? Sin c value is equals 1 by mu. This is sin c value. You see here, sin c value is 1 by mu. We have the value of sin c as well as what cos c. Therefore, tan c is equals to sin c by cos c. Sin c is 1 by mu. Cos c is equal to under root mu square minus 1 by mu. So that can be written as what? R is equal to h by under root mu square minus 1. This simplification. Mu mu cancel. So 1 by under root mu square minus 1 is r by h. Therefore, radius of the circular aperture is given by what? Height of the what? Illuminated object from the surface by under root mu square minus 1. Mu is called refractive index. H is the height. And r is the radius of the conic section or circular aperture. So this is a very, very important formula, children. Please, all of you, practice this once, twice, thrice. So the so much information is there related to what? The refraction at the plane surfaces. It is a very, very useful derivation for you solving the problems. So many problems we come across from this. It's a very good and important model. Thank you very much.